Hi everyone, welcome to this Twinmotion Tips and Tricks video. Today we'll be looking at some behind the scenes of this Night City project that we created for the community challenge number 6. In this video, we'll check how we created this kind of holographic display that you can see here on this part of the project. It's a subtle detail, especially when you see the full image, it's just on one edge of the project, but still there is some tips to be said there. So the first thing I'm going to do is actually just select my holographic display and just move it in the middle of our path over here. And what I will do is actually create the same object directly inside Twinmotion. Like indeed, I didn't use any geometry coming from my CAD application. I created all of that directly inside Twinmotion. To have a better preview inside Twinmotion, I will get out of this final image and switch to a more panoramic view so you can just better preview the object I'm working on. So the first thing I did is to open the library, I drag and dropped a basic box. And on this basic box, what I did is just apply a simple poster that you can find inside the library. So I just apply this basic poster over here. I'm using this box just for easy alignment of the poster so it's straight. Then what I did is on this poster, I loaded my texture. So what I will do is here using the material picker, I will select the material. But as you can see on the Twinmotion native material, there is not an opacity slider. As you can see here, my material, my texture is a bit transparent. So what I did actually is go inside Photoshop and lower the texture opacity directly in Photoshop and load inside Twinmotion a texture which have a lower opacity. Let's actually do that together. Here I have my texture open and what I will simply do is use the opacity option over here and switch to something around 30% of opacity. As you can see right now, you can barely see the texture inside Photoshop, but you will see it way better inside Twinmotion. I will save that as a PNG file. As you can see here, I already saved those textures, but let me just maybe rename, create a new one like OPA 30. As a PNG, so the opacity will remain present inside the texture itself. And now what I will do back inside Twinmotion is come on toward my poster, come to the more of the color control, and here I will load my texture, the OPA 31. As you can see right now, you can barely see it, but still, the texture is transparent, you can see it through. Now let's actually load some glow on it. So what I will do is select on this control, on the texture control, what I will do is click here and click on copy. We'll come back here, come to the settings. I will raise the glow option. By default, it uses a white color, but in the more here, I can simply load and paste my texture. And as you can see now, it's glowing based on the texture itself I've loaded. Start to look great, like I can see now my texture glowing. Let me just maybe change a bit the scale of it. I have my texture that is glowing and I can actually see through it. Now the next step was to add actually a light in front of my poster. So what I did is just come to the light folder, select an area light, place it over here. I will just change the orientation like that. Switch the lens to something around 0.8 maybe, and the height something around 1.2 maybe. Yeah, more 1. And here what I need to do also is to change the color, so to make sure it matches a bit the color I have on my texture. So I went to the more over here, and I switched to something a bit on those lines. And I also just lower the intensity. Right now it's a bit too bright. Yeah, more something like that, a bit more subtle. Finally, one of the last thing I did is to create this basic geometry at the bottom. I won't create that, it's really simple. It's just basic box that I scale on one axis. Then I added some cylinder on which I apply a glowing material. And finally, what I did is just place this spotlight over here. As you can see, it just, let me actually duplicate one over here. Spotlight is pretty basic. It have an attenuation of 0.5, so it's the spotlight itself is really small. Then I've used a really low intensity because what I wanted to focus on with those spotlights are actually the small haze effect that you can see over here. Again, it's really subtle, but if you just place it at the bottom, let me actually remove the cube, we don't need it anymore. Just place it at the bottom of my basic poster. I'm going to duplicate that a couple of times. That gives a bit the illusion of like the holographic coming from the ground, like I did over here. It's better, of course, with the small glowing cylinder, making sure like the lights, the spotlight are aligned with this cylinder. And it creates a nice subtle effect that works well for the futuristic kind of scene I wanted to create for this challenge. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and I will see you for the next one. Bye everyone!